presenting sponsors.
Coverage of the 2014 IHSAA Boys State Basketball Championship presented by the Indiana Pacers and the Indiana Fever on Fox Sports Indiana continue. Up next, the 4A title game between the Titans of Arsenal Technical High School in Indianapolis and another representative, Lake Central's Indians, both with terrific records, both outstanding programs. We welcome you inside Bankers Life Fieldhouse, Jerry Baker, Mike Broughton. We've got three down, Mike, one to go here. We expect a Tech, for the most part, to be here. That's no surprise. Lake Central, that's a little different. A lot of folks thought either Hamilton Southeastern or Carmel would get here. You've seen them play. What do you think?
Well, Lake Central's fundamentally sound. Weidman's a tough guy on the inside. He's physical, big, played on the junior all-star team. In fact, I watch him play against Lyles every day for a week almost in practice. And so he's ready for the task. He's going to Butler, and Lake Central's going to be a worthy opponent for Tech tonight.
Well, the route to get here for the Tech Titans was not all that easy. They had to beat a couple of ranked ball clubs, 14th ranked Lawrence Central in the Lawrence North Sectional, then 7th ranked Richmond in the Southport Regional. Last week they rolled over Bloomington North, 75-71. They've got another candidate for Mr. Basketball and Trey Lyles.
Trey Lyles at 24 points and 12 rebounds going to Kentucky. He's got a great sidekick in the Walker kid and the Tyler kid, and so they're very well sound. They're very sound, and they're worthy of being in the final game because they've taken all comers so far.
Tech coached by Jason Delaney. We'll talk about him a little later on. He's already won one state championship. The trip down here to Bankers Life for Lake Central, they won the East Chicago Central Sectional. Michigan City Regional, they had to beat number 6 Penn. They got by a couple of points there, 57-55, knocked off Homestead, another ball club a lot of folks thought might get here. They handled them easily. Tyler Weidman is their lead guy.
15.7 rebounds a game, and against Penn, he made the winning shot at the buzzer to go 57-55.
Well, Dave Malashnik is the head coach in his 10th year at Lake Central High School. This game will be somewhat different than the 3A game, which was hectic up and down the court. So we've got to get a feel of how this game is going to play out. A lot of folks are here. Tech's brought a bunch of people, so has Lake Central. Starting lineups of the opening tip-off are coming up in just a moment on Fox Sports Indiana.
Back on.
The 104th annual IHSAA Boys State Finals are brought to you by the Indiana Pacers and Indiana Fever, presenting sponsor of the IHSAA State Basketball Tournament and honored to support Indiana's game at all levels. And by Methodist Sports Medicine in collaboration with IU Health, official sports medicine provider to the IHSAA. Subway, eat fresh. Wilson Sporting Goods, the official ball of the IHSAA. Farmers Insurance, we are insurance, we are farmers. The Indianapolis Colts, the IHSAA is proud to be Colt Strong. Sharp Business Systems, saluting great athletes and even better students. Sport Graphics, turning our creativity and experience into your results. And by Fox Sports Indiana, home of the IHSAA Champions Network. And you head a look at Monument Circle downtown. Here's the 4A lineup, the Tech Titans and the Lake Central Indians. Time now for the keys to the game, brought to you by Wilson Sporting Goods, the official ball of the IHSAA. Tech will be the visitors. Mike Rotten, let's take a look at their keys to the game.
Well, I think Tech, with the 19-point victory at Christmas, they need to avoid overconfidence. They need to be ready to go right out of the gate. They need to stay out of foul trouble, especially Lyles. He needs to stay out of foul trouble. And then Pike in the regional, as well as in the semi-state, a little bit of gimmick defense and some triangles and some diamond and ones that kind of bothered Tech. They have to be ready for those. For Lake Central, they must forget about the loss to Tech. They got to be active right here at the beginning of the game. They need to get back on defense, because Tech gets a lot of runouts, rebounds, and go. And then they need to limit the 8-0 scoring runs, and that's just those long runs where Tech will get four or five baskets in a row. You got to kill those with timeouts.
All right, let's go to the sideline now. Bring Greg back in. Greg?
And fellas, obviously, it's the game that is most important. They're playing for a state championship, but kind of the side conversation that we can have during this game is the race for Mr. Basketball. Most folks have identified this as a three-man race. James Blackman Jr. of Marion, bound for Indiana University, but his Giants lost in a sectional semifinal game at Kokomo. Trayvon Blewett just picked up his third state title in 4 years and leading Park Tudor to the 2A state championship this morning. And of course, Trayvon had 38 points and 12 rebounds in the process. A lot of folks might think that Trey Lyles is the front runner for the award. He can maybe put the stamp on it with a big game and leading Tech to their first state title and the first for an IPS school since 1980. Jerry.
That IPS situation has been something they've been talking about here in the Indianapolis area for the past, well, almost since the tournament began, because it's been so long. We'll talk more about that, since an IPS school won a state title. Tech 26-2, Lake Central 22-3. Starting lineups coming up, opening tip-off in just a moment on the Champions Television Network. A little bit about these two schools. Starting off at Tech, the school was established in 1912, originally a U.S. Civil War arsenal, which was closed after the Spanish-American War. Most of the original buildings for the arsenal still there due to the arsenal and school buildings that had existed on the campus for such a long time. Tech High School was placed on the National Register of Historic Places back in 1976. If you've ever been out there, it is quite a school. And for the folks from up north in Lake Central, this was a school that's not quite that old. They opened up back in 1967. Current high school succeeded an older school named Dyer Central High School. They're located, by the way, in case you're not familiar, in St. John, Indiana. It's about 150 miles northwest of Indy, 12 miles south of Hammond. Getting ready for the introduction of the starting lineups of the entire squads. That's coming up next on the IHSAA Champions Network. That graphic tells you all you need to know. 4A championship is coming up. Time now for the starting lineups presented tonight for this 4A championship game by our good friends at Subway. Here's Scott Gregg.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Indianapolis and Bankers Life Fieldhouse for the 104th annual Boys Basketball State Finals. Our game tonight is for the Class 4A Championship and features the Indianapolis Arsenal Technical Titans and the Lake Central Indians. Here are your rosters and starting lineups for tonight's 4A championship game. First for Indianapolis Tech. Number roster and starting lineup for the Lake Central Indians. Number 3, Robert Ryan. Number 4, Matt Meneghetti. Number 5, Ian Martin. Number 10, Gage Ray. Number 14, Skylar Smith. And the starting lineup for the Indians of Lake Central at guard, a 6-foot senior, number 2, Ty Wilburn. Guard, a 5-foot 10-inch junior, number 12, Joe Bannister.
But the coaches, Tech coached by Jason Delaney. In his third year at the school, he won the Class A state championship back in 2004 with a team from Waldron. They were 27-0 that year. Overall, 10 years, 144-90. Jason Delaney, Lake Central, Dave Miloshnik, 139-79 in his 10th year at Lake Central High School, a graduate of Highland High School in Ball State. His father, Mickey, was an assistant coach at East Chicago, Washington, on the bench for that 1977 title game against Carmel, which they lost 53-52. And while I'm thinking about it, Mike, we got just a second. I wanted to commend Josh Brunsting of Arsenal Tech High School. He sang the national anthem tonight and just did a session two, I should say. And then tonight, the Arsenal Tech Choir did the national anthem. He had done back home again in Indiana, and the choir from Tech was just outstanding.
Both of them were good, and then where I'm from, Jennings County High School, they were the flag bearers tonight, and they did a quality job as well, and I was glad they made it up here and had a good weekend. A
lot of folks getting involved with these games. You saw the officials, Tom Rohr, Scott Arthur, Dean Martin. And we're ready to go now. Tech will be in the dark uniforms, Lake Central in the white uniforms. And again, Mike, this will be very much unlike the game we just saw in 3A. What do you expect here?
Well, it's going to be a physical contest is what it's going to be. And the baskets are going to be tough because both teams play really good defense.
Lake Central averages 67-6 a game. Tech 77 a game. But defensively, they're both pretty darn good. We'll keep an eye on that. So again, with the white uniforms, Lake Central 22-3 on the year. As we mentioned, averaging almost 68 points a game. They get it down left side, Wilburn. Outside the goal, they got the jumper up and good by Weidman. He's the key right now.
He's the key man. He can shoot the 15, 16-foot shot. He can also post up. Tech started man-to-man, and Lake Central's man-to-man.
And the guy to look for Tech is that man right there, Trey Lyles. Now they'll focus on him. You wonder what kind of a junk defense they might toss at him. Right now, all they're doing is putting Corey Dickelman all over him.
They tried to double, left the back end open, but good block out by Dickelman that time on Lyles.
Walker misses the shot. They turn it over going the other way. Lake Central's first turnover of the game. They get the driving layup and get the bucket.
Excellent pass by Lyles on the break that time. You don't see many 6'10 guys can do that.
So Lyles will end up being one of the guys we'll just spot throughout the game. No question about that. He's averaging 24 points and 13 rebounds. And Tech gets the early lead in this ball game. We're making a 2-2 tie, I should say. And the put back up and good. Weidman again. Fourth point now for Tyler.
Weidman big and strong on the inside. Lake Central did a great job reversing the basketball, getting it inside.
Knocked out of bounds, and it'll belong to Lake Central.
So Lake Central's decided, the coaching staff has decided to play Dickelman on Lyles. That's to keep Weidman probably out of foul trouble, especially early in the first quarter. Maybe later in the game they'll have to match up and go at each other, but right now they're trying to save him.
Well, Dickelman is 6'4", Lyles 6'10". Now Dickelman does not score a lot, just under 6 points and just under 4 rebounds. Here's the block, out of bounds, stays in the hands of Lake Central.
First possession, they had Dickelman guard him, and then they sent down Ty Wilburn to double on Lyles, and he kind of faded away on the first shot. He needs to attack the basket.
As we talked about earlier, Tech won the first meeting of the year between these two ball clubs and won it by a score that was perhaps not indicative of how the game went. Lake Central lost 61-80, 80-61. They led 42-40 midway through the third, so they were very much in that ball game. Quickly, Tech getting back up court. Mikey Jones dropped down inside to Walker and outside for the long range three. That is good by Mikey Jones.
Nice shot by Mikey Jones on the outside, and Tech's up one.
Tech school colors are green, white, and red. It seems like that, I'm not sure what shade of green you call that, Mike, but I've been around Tech for a long, long time, and that's just their color. That's all there is to it. Up court they go, and they get the jam.
That was Tyler on the run that time, going to Ball State. He's a big-time talent, a big-time player.
He has 4 of the 7 on the board right now, a 3-point lead. And out of bounds, it'll go back the other way to the Tech Titans. Here comes that smash again.
That's just a big-time play when you can get up at a guard position at about 10'5", 10'6", and stuff it down.
Tech on a 5-0 run after they had fallen behind. And they can explode. Defensively, they give up 59.8 points a game. Lake Central's defense, very good, only allowing 47.5 points per contest over the 25 games this year. Mikey Jones shuffles it off now to Whitfield. Oh, what a good-looking pass inside to Tyler again from Lyles.
See, that's the difference in Lyles from this year to last. He's on balance. He can see the floor, make the good pass, as well as put in 25 most nights.
Unbelievable stuff. He averages 24 points, 13 rebounds. He is second on the team in assists, Mike, with 996 coming into the state championship game.
He's got two right now early in the basketball game. Done a good job on defense right there against Weidman.
He is also third in the ball club and steals with 22. That's the fourth turnover of the game and a whistle. Four turnovers now against Lake Central early on in this contest.
Well, Weidman, right, Lyles right now on the outside, two great passes. He's attacking the basket, and he's also guarding Weidman right now, which I'm a little surprised, but he's taking him on. He's taking Lake Central's best player on.
Tyler Ross commits the personal foul now for Lake Central. It's the first foul of the game on Lake Central, so obviously a long way from having any shots. Halfway through the first quarter, pull-up jumper outside, no good. Sky for the rebound. That's Tyler Weidman, averaging just under 7 rebounds a game and scoring just under 16 points per game. Weidman and Lyles are the guys you want to keep your eye on as far as the key cogs for these two teams.
Great job that time by Tech on the ball screen, jumping out and attacking the ball screen.
Got a timeout with 3:46 to go in the first quarter. Tech 9, Lake Central 4 on the IHSAA Champions Television Network. Lake Central had a 2-point lead a few minutes ago, Mike, but they have gone now almost 3 minutes without scoring.
That's kind of the question for Lake Central. You have Weidman at 16 points a game, but then who else can score? And right now Weidman has four. The team has four. Somebody else has to get with it here. The kid that came in the game right now, this Matt Benengetti, he is an automatic shoot a three every time he catches it, and really the distance doesn't make any difference. Last week in the semi-state, they played him box and one. In fact, Tech right now is trying to find him. Number four for Lake Central.
Yeah, the only other player scoring in double figures for Lake Central is Ty Wilbur, number two. He averages 12.3 points a game. You mentioned Benengetti. He is 57 for 129 from the three-point zone. That's 44%.
They're going to try to get him open, and his range is about 25, 26 feet, and the crowd jumps up every time he's ready to shoot it.
In fact, the opposing crowds have been getting on him throughout the year.
Shoot it.
Now, he's not bashful. He's not afraid
there
of it.
There it is.
Didn't go this time, but the rebound comes off to Lyle. Tech wants to run, but Lake Central doing a nice job getting back defensively. 3 minutes to play. Opening quarter. Class 4A state championship game. Bankers Life Fieldhouse. Jumper outside is good. Nice looking shot that time by Jeremy Tyler. He's having a great start. 8 points for him already.
58% from the field, 42 from three, and 16 points a game.
Yeah, he's averaged. He's got half his average right now. He's also an excellent outside shooter from the three-pointer. They try to go backdoor that time, and it's intercepted by Tyler. Long range three, nothing. Rebound on the floor, chased down, but out of bounds. It'll go back to Lake Central. One of the things, and you mentioned, you touched on this, one of the things I've noticed as Justin Parker comes in with Trey Lyles over the past couple of years, Mike, is he has matured into a player, not just a star, but a player in addition to being a star.
No, he's a player. Next year at Kentucky, he's going to get a lot of minutes. Oh, yeah. And probably in 2-3 years, he's going to be in the NBA. He's just that good a player.
2:12 to go here in the opening quarter. 11-4 Titans. And I think it's imperative that Lake Central stay very, very close in this game. They cannot make any kind of a strong comeback against them. Backdoor cut, nothing doing. Second shot, no good. And the foul, Lyles, you can hear it clear over here.
Lyles doing a great job on defense against Weidman. He's getting bent down, attacking him. And the ball just kind of happened to bounce to Lake Central that time so he could get two free throws.
Got a lot of ball, but I think he also got some body down low. There's a good look at Trey.
He did a good job on Weidman that time because Weidman wants to turn to shoot with his right hand. Lyles was shading, did a good job on the first block, but somebody from Tech's got to come in and clean it up.
In that game earlier this year, Lyles had 20 points and 10 rebounds. Tyler had 14 in that game. And for Lake Central, Weidman had 16 points and 17 rebounds. Wilburn had 16 and 4. Way off mark. And
that time,
you can see Lyles.
Weidman hit him right on the arm, and that ball missed the bankboard.
Missed everything.
You know, I don't.
Let's look at it again here.
He went up and
he couldn't see it there.
Yeah, he went up and just got slapped from where I was sitting. He just got slapped, and he looked at the referee and shook his head and ran down the court. It's what happens.
Lake Central shot 41% on that first meeting this year, 21 of 51. Tech shot 57% on 24 of 42. Picked up by Tech, inside layup, no good, and a foul.
Right now, Tech's just beating them to the basketball on both ends of the court. They're attacking on offense, getting most of the rebounds on defense.
Menengetti with a foul. That's the first of the ball game on this young man. His tournament average, by the way, off the bench is 10.8 points. He's number one golfer on the Lake Central team. He's going to Carthage College. That's in Kenosha, Wisconsin. First free throw up and good. His father, Matt Sr., is the golf pro at Purdue Calumet. And head coach Dave Miloshnik says of Menengetti, in my tenure, he's the best three-point shooter we've ever had.
On the semi-state, he just Homestead went zone, and he was just automatic, and that's why they're here today after the semi-state victory.
Tech on an 11-0 run. They were down 4-2. Up 13-4 right now. Going away, another turnover. That is 7 now for Lake Central.
Well, the ball screen, they jumped out and hedged it. Indianapolis Tech hedged it. And then they had a guy gambling on the backside, and that play is going to die for Lake Central. They don't have any chance really to get anything done on that play because they're just getting stuffed right off the ball screen.
Lake Central averages 12.5 turnovers a game, and as I mentioned, they already have 7 of the first quarter with just under a minute to go. Here's Lyle. And he will draw the foul. You notice that time, Mike, they had single coverage. Then as he moved to the basket, two other white shirts came in to say, let's join the party here.
Yeah, that time they put Weidman on him. So they've kind of switched men. They're now going Weidman against Lyles. And probably they were going to do that for one or two fouls. And Weidman got his first. He had to get his hands straight up.
Third team foul against Lake Central. Lyles, 74% from the line.
Lyles has been awful impressive at this beginning of the game. I think after last week's semi-state where they were up 30 and it got down to 3 points against Bloomington North, I think that really was a wake-up call for Tech because they're really into this game, much more than they were at the regional against Pike and the other day against Bloomington North. I mean, they look like a team of destiny right now. They're really getting after it.
I talked to, second free throw is good. I talked to Jason Delaney about that very thing on Monday. I said, do you realize that at that time, Bloomington North was down by 3 and had the ball? And he said, yeah. He said, let me tell you something. That won't happen again. And he said, I took the starters out too early. I shouldn't have done that. And then he had to put them back in the game. And you know, that just disrupts the flow of the game to a certain degree. He told me, point blank, that ain't going to happen again.
I don't know if he's even going to sub.
No, he may not. He may not. Here's Lyles finding the open man long range. Deep at the corner right side now is Walker. And Lyles goes in for the rebound, had it slapped away by Weidman, but picked back up by the Titans.
You better be physical to rebound the basketball. In
2 seconds,
game.
1 second, they will shoot at the buzzer and just miss it. So we've gone through 8 minutes of the 4A championship game. It is 14-4 in favor of the Tech Titans. Fox Sports Indiana, presented by the Indiana Pacers and the Indiana Fever. Well, 10-point lead now for Arsenal Tech, their biggest of the game, and I got a feeling the first quarter stats are going to be kind of ugly if you're a Lake Central fan.
Yeah, 2 of 10. Weidman made both shots. No one else has really been able to help out. Lake Central does lead in rebounding 10-6, but pretty well dominated by Tech's defense in the first quarter.
Well, that young man right there is Trey Lyles. Did not get off to a great start. He had only 1 point in the quarter. Three by Mikey Jones. Jeremy Tyler was the key with 10.
Yeah, Jeremy Tyler. Pike's coaching staff must have known something, because 2 weeks ago they played Tyler in a diamond and won and chased him the whole game. So they knew what they were doing in that game.
Tech of the dark uniforms. Lake Central in white. Shot baseline, no good. And the foul's going to be called against Lake Central's number 22. That'll be Dickelman. That'll be number one on him. And Lyles will go back to the line.
I know Coach Belosnik would really be upset about that play, because they forced Lyles outside 17 feet. It was a 2-point shot, and Dickelman had to grab him.
Lyles, of course, headed to the University of Kentucky. He was the state's Gatorade Player of the Year, 3-time City Player of the Year, and honored before the December 13th game against Cathedral as Tech's all-time leading scorer in a pregame presentation with the man that he passed on that list, Frank Kendrick. Got them both.
Lake Central right now has to take care of the basketball, and they need to get a really good shot this possession down.
Now they're in that danger zone right now. Down 16-4. And they're going to go to the line.
That time Wilburn drove the ball to the basket. Now they use him a lot off ball screens in the tournament, but since he's really getting trapped in the ball screen, they just took it off the dribble that time. He got to the inside. He had a really good game against Homestead last week. He made some key drives late in the game for them to pull out the victory.
Foul was on Mikey Jones, number one on him. Ty Wilburn, only a 59% free throw shooter, knocks down the first one. And he is the first player to score other than Weidman in the game.
Yeah, they got to get somebody going. Maybe it'll be Wilburn.
Ty is a 6-foot senior, averaging 12.3 points.
You don't see many 6'10 guys bringing the ball down the court
in high school. Although that's changing even at the college level now. 6'10 point guard dribbling it up. UCLA had one of them.
Great defense by Dickelman that time on the inside against Lyles.
First turnover of the game, and to get the bucket at the other end, Ty Wilburn Only the third field goal of the game so far for Lake Central.
Wilburn, great quickness on the drive that time.
Lyles, baseline right side.
Right-hander, 15-foot floater by a 6'10".
We mentioned he averages 24 points a game, but his assists and steals have just been climbing with each passing year. You really wonder if he had to score the 35 or 40 points. I think he could if he had to, but he doesn't have to. He's got a good, well-balanced ball club, but they're going to need help because they don't have that many guys scoring in double figures. Long three. Rebound, Lyles. Whips it out up court, trying to get the ball into the hands of Justin Parker, and they turn it over now. Second turnover in a row for the Titans. Right down the lane, alley-oop, blocked by Lyles. He has 64 blocks coming into the game, and they get it right up court into the hands of C.J. Walker.
Coach Malosnik calling timeout. This is a good timeout for Lake Central. They're rattled right now.
They are down 20-8. And showing not much ability at this particular juncture to do much about it. Here's the steal that comes back the other way by Wilburn. And that is, get it out of here, Lyles.
That's a great block. And then Walker drives the ball to the basket on the spin. Now, he's the only freshman at the Hall of Fame tournament ever to be all tournament. Last year, they were in the Hall of Fame. He's the first and only freshman ever to make the Hall of Fame all tournament team. Nice move there. Plus, he got a little bit of stare down after that.
Yes, he did. In fact, I was waiting for the tee to maybe show up down there.
Well, he was proud of the basket, but he just needs to run back on defense.
Tech won the city tournament, beating Covenant Christian, Bishop Chatard, Indianapolis Howe, Indianapolis Cathedral. In fact, they scored 100 points against Chatard and 97 against Covenant Christian. During the regular season, they averaged 78.5 points, 71-7 of the tournament, 77 overall. And their average win margin of the regular season was 19.1, and during the tournament, 18-2. So they've been consistent all season long, both preseason, regular season, and tournament play. Here's a steal. Lake Central's eighth turnover of the game at the other end. Wild collision and out of bounds.
Good move by Coach Delaney right there. He went 1-3-1 half-court trap. Lake Central wasn't ready for it. They turned the ball over, and Tech attacks the basket.
Second foul on Corey Dickelman. And we will see Justin Parker at the line. 66% free throw shooter. He has not scored yet in the game.
Parker made some big baskets in the regional against Indianapolis Pike, especially in the second half. And again, Tech with 1-3-1 half-court trap, changed things a little bit. Good move by the coaching staff at Tech.
Parker is a transfer from Northwest High School last summer, Northwest on the west side of Indy.
1-3-1 half-court trap again against Lake Central. Tech in it. Lyles in the middle.
13-point leads, the biggest of the ball game now for Tech.
They're going to try to get Minighetti the shot, I would imagine, if they get it ball reversed.
Oh, what a hard-earned bucket by Ty Wilburn.
He beat three players on the drive that time. One of them was Lyles.
It's 6 points now for him. And again, a foul prior to the shot. So no shots involved.
You're just seeing some fantastic athleticism in this game by Walker, Wilburn, Lyles, Tyler. It's fun to watch. Everybody's getting their money's worth today.
Yeah, they truly have. Joe Bannister, by the way, on the personal foul. This is the fourth game of the day, one of which was an overtime. The Class A game. Three-pointer rattles in, rattles out. Rebound comes off into the hands of Weidman. 3 minutes gone. Second quarter. Pull-up jumper. No. No numbers on the break. The Titan will set it up outside again, and a traveling violation as he flips it back out to the guards. Third turnover now for the Titans. I mentioned the Titans average about 11 turnovers per game. That's not bad.
Wilburn's doing a good job. Got some life to him on Lake Central on offense, but he's got to attack the basket. He's a 21% three-point shooter. He's got to get inside.
Tech was preseason ranked number one in the state by the basketball coaches who ranked the schools with no regard to class, just all in one class. He was number one there. He was ranked, the Associated Press had Tech ranked number five in the state.
This isn't the start Lake Central wanted, but if they could get a couple baskets together here and get it back down inside double digits, they'll be okay.
C.J. Walker's first foul. And again, it's only the third foul against Tech so far in this game. Inside Weidman, had it knocked free. And a match scramble again, picked up by the Titans. They got it off into the hands of Lyles. Lyles in a hurry, up court now to Walker. Missed it, put back up by Lyles.
Great drive by Walker. Nice play by Lyles following the shot. He's active on both ends of the floor. Weidman's trying to make too many plays on the inside. He needs to attack the basket.
23-10, 13-point margin again now for Tech. You know, we talked about Menengedi. That was him with the ball, number four. He can't get free to take a shot.
No, Tech, as soon as Menengedi came in, they went back man-to-man instead of the 1-3-1, so Menengedi's running around trying to get open, but they're shutting him off.
That's just a good job of scouting is what that is. Rebound offensively by Weidman. Now here he is. And the rebound comes off the Tech again. Knocked away. You know, I've not heard anybody say anything. Well, we'll take a timeout. We'll come back and chat with that in a minute. 3:36 to go here in the first half. So far, it's all Tech. They're up 23-10 over Lake Central for the 4A championship. What I was going to say, Mike, is this is the facility, of course, that the Indiana Pacers and the Indiana Fever use, but it's still a different surroundings for a guy like Menengedi, who is used to shooting in a smaller arena. I'm not making an excuse for him, but this is a learning experience.
Well, it's a deep background. I mean, you shoot, it's like shooting at the park because you have such a deep background and no walls. So they're having trouble, but a lot of it's because of Tech's defense is doing a great job.
Funny how that works, isn't it? Here comes Lyles. Tried to drop it off to one of the cutters down the lane and let it get away.
Lyles and Weidman are trying to become, trying to be great passers in this quarter. They just need to go to the basket and get the thing up there.
They're not just missing threes, they're not even close. Here's Lyles, pull up 18-footer. And back up and again and no good, but a foul call.
Good rebound on the inside on Parker, Justin Parker. He really went over Lake Central. There was no block out. He was able to get the ball and attack the basket.
Lyda Ross gets his second foul of the game. Tech shooting 8 of 17. Lake Central 4 of 17. Rebounds 12 to 11. Lake Central actually leads the rebounding bracket.
I think Coach Malosnik, he needs to really work this next possession on trying to get the thing inside and attack the basket. And they can go to Weidman and then play out of that. But they're really getting pushed out on the perimeter. Indianapolis Tech now coming out in a 2-2-1 press.
Parker gets them both. He has 3 points. Justin averages 5.7 a game. 2:55 to go, first half.
Now they're trying to match up out of, they're trying to play 2-3 zone, I believe.
There's the cut inside. And Weidman comes off with the rebound momentarily, puts it back up, misses the shot, draws the foul, will go to the line.
That was a big time rebound on the inside by Weidman. He got punched right in the face, and he's doing some, he's bleeding quite bad right now.
That foul is on Parker. That'll be the first of the game on him. We're going to have to.
He's got some blood.
Get him out of the game. Boy, he does, big time. Tyler Weidman for Lake Central. Weidman is going to Butler. And based on the season they had, they could use some meat like that over there. A kid that's fighting hard. Weidman, tournament average, 13.5 points and 4.8 rebounds.
I think he got hit above the eye, or it was right below the eye, and went up for the rebound, and had aggressive play. That's going to be a tough break for Lake Central because they're already kind of scrambling right now. But here's good hustle by Weidman. He beats Lyles to the ball. He goes up, and somewhere along the line, he got hit there in the face.
Didn't see it, did you?
No, I did not see it, but he got hit because his uniform had a lot of blood on it as he's walking off the court.
And
so Menengetti's going to shoot the free throws, but Lake Central becomes a much smaller team right now.
Again, for the IHSAA, there are always medical people on duty. In fact, they are told, the schools, bring your own if you want, but we will have people here. So he'll be well taken care of. We haven't seen the extent of the damage. I don't know if it's going to require stitches or what the situation might be, but you're right, Mike. They've got to have him back in there somehow.
Now, he's got to get back in the game, so they got to get the blood.
Greg, let's go over to you.
Behind Tyler Weidman, guys, and the trainer from Lake Central just asked for the medical assistance from the folks at Methodist Sports Medicine. I'm not going to try to be a medical professional here. My guess is I'm not sure that they can just simply stop the bleeding by applying something to it. This may almost require stitches at halftime or a bandage wrap around the forehead like we saw from Wellage in the last game. It's going to take a while to get this blood stopped and cleaned up on Weidman, Jerry.
All right, so what we've got now is a situation then, Mike, where Lake Central right now just has to stem the tide, just try to get through the final 2.5 minutes of the first half.
Yeah, 15, it's kind of desperate straits right now, but they got to slow it down. They go back in. They're going back in 2-3 zone.
Three-point shot that's nowhere near. Wilburn comes out of there with it. They get numbers on the break. He goes all the way inside. And they'll throw it back out again. Long-range three, Bannister. Rebound comes off to Robert Ryan, who's on the floor for the first time. 6'5", 8 senior.
Bannister.
And the turnover.
Bannister hit two big threes in the semi-state game that took it from about a six-point game to 12. He missed a little long that time, but he's a guy that maybe could hit a couple threes and get him back in the game.
10th turnover of the first half for Lake Central. And I made reference to the fact they only turn it over about 12.5 times per game. Bodies everywhere. On the break. Once again, Lyles. That's at least two blocks in the game. And a foul again.
Well, Lake Central right now is very, very frustrated in their play. When you don't make shots, you start getting upset at both ends of the court. And that happened to Menengetti right there as he just reached and grabbed the guy and pushed him down.
Second foul on Matt. Our game being brought to you by, presented by our friends of the Indiana Pacers and the Indiana Fever on Fox Sports Indiana. 1:41 to go, first half. Free throw by Whitfield.
There's not much Lake Central can do right now if they can't score the basketball. They, like you said, they got a minute 41. They really need to be patient this next possession down the court and just try to get something because Weidman's heading to the locker room.
And we'll see. Greg checked on him, and we're going to see what the situation is, what they're going to do with him at halftime. I just hope the young man is able to come back. He deserves to be in this ball game. And okay. We were told that when he does come back, he'll have a new jersey. They can't play with any blood on the uniform, that he'll be changed his number to 33. Nice little shot about 10 feet out on the left side by Chris Tuscan.
That was 6 or 7 nice passes, and they didn't rush anything. That was great for Lake Central.
Alley-oop, and threw it over the arms of Trey Lyles, which is no easy task.
Yeah, that lob pass over Menengetti. Menengetti got up underneath Lyles and did a great job bodying him there.
Five turnovers on Tech.
I think he was giving up about a foot in size and did a great job fighting.
1 minute to go in the first half. Well, they hit Tuscan down low again, but there's just no way to get the ball down to him. Rebound Lyles with 42 seconds to go in the half. Lyles now with 7 rebounds already in the first half. And I mentioned he averages 12-9.
Watch for Tyler against the zone right here. He's in the left corner, and they're going to try to run the clock down and get Lake Central extended here.
Now we're down to 20 seconds.
We'll go back in that 2-3 zone now.
Now we're down to 10.
Watch out for Tyler. He's got the ball. Lyles.
Three-pointer, air ball, picked up and put back up, and it would have counted had it gone. Shot was tipped in, but too late. So they worked the ball for about 45 or so seconds, didn't get anything out of it, but they really didn't need it at this juncture, because at halftime they're up 27-12. I would think right now Jason DeLady's got to be a pretty happy guy. Let's go get his thoughts now.
Jason, an outstanding defensive effort. Your thoughts about just the work on that end of the floor in the first 16 minutes?
I mean, I think offensively we've got to attack more. We're settling for a lot of jumpers right now, and some shots just aren't falling. That shot there by Mike just doesn't fall. Defensively, we've had a couple of breakdowns. I mean, you got to be happy with 12, but I think we can be better because a couple of the defensive fundamental principles that we continue to work on broke down a couple times, and they've gotten good looks at them. But we just got to keep attacking. We got to keep moving without the basketball, and they're going to double, triple team Trey, so we got to find the open gaps in the offense.
Any specific message to your team at halftime, Jason?
Don't let up.
It sounds good. Lesson learned from last week. Best of luck.
Thank you.
Jerry?
Only 3 players have scored for Lake Central, and the entire starting five has scored for Tech. At halftime, 27 for Arsenal Technical High School, Lake Central 12. Watching the 4A championship and the IHSAA Champions Television Network, presented by the Pacers and the Beavers. Yeah, that score pretty well tells you what kind of a game it's been in the first half. Tech jumping out to a 27-12 lead. Let's revisit the keys to the game, starting off with the Tech Titans.
Well, Tech, they weren't overconfident because they really attacked Lake Central right out of the gate. They stayed out of foul trouble. They've done a great job there. And Lake Central's played straight man pretty much, tried to double on Lyles a little bit, handled it well. For Lake Central, must forget the loss to Tech. I don't know. They've really struggled in the first half shooting the basketball. They got back on defense pretty well, and of course, if you'd only scored 12 points, Tech's going to have some runs on you, and they've had some 8-0, 10-0 runs, so they really struggled there.
But you're watching the IHSAA Class 4 State High School Basketball Tournament. There is your score. Back with more at halftime in just a moment.
Welcome back. It is halftime at Bankers Life Fieldhouse. Tech enjoying a 27-12 lead over Lake Central. We've been pleased to be joined by Pacers guests throughout the course of the day, and we end that with the president of Pacers Sports Entertainment. It is Jim Morris. Jim, it is always good to see you. And on behalf of the IHSAA and their fans everywhere, thank you for the Pacers and Fever support of this event.
It's terrific. You know, like most things, you get an awful lot more back than you give. For us to be a part of this is extraordinary. A great crowd, great competition, great sportsmanship. To have all these folks in our building, in our downtown, It's extraordinary.
You have really the last couple of years really tried to, I shouldn't say branch out, but just kind of embrace the fact in marketing, saying, hey, this is Indiana's game and we're Indiana's team, and this is obviously playing a major support in the sport at the grassroots level.
Well, for us, for the Pacers and the Fever, to have a relationship with every girls' team, every boys' team in high school basketball all across the state of Indiana, for us to share and to do this in common, and for us to support them and help them, is a great thing. It's terrific, good for everybody.
Well, this season as a whole has been a great thing for you and the team. Best of luck keeping that going well into June as the playoffs get started.
Well, we're excited. We've got a great, both the Pacers and the Fever are terrific. The Pacers, great young men, great coaches. And we're going to make the state of Indiana proud this year.
Of course, the Pacers back in action tomorrow against the Cleveland Cavaliers, back home against the Spurs on Monday night. Jerry and Mike return in a moment here on Fox Sports Indiana.
Lake Central scoring 4 points in the first quarter, 8 in the second. They're down by 15. We take a look at the Methodist Sports Medicine first half highlights. Methodist Sports Medicine in collaboration with IU Health, the official sports medicine provider to the IHSAA. That's the guy they're going to miss right there, Tyler Whiteman. He is out. We're not sure when he'll be back. This is the move by Wilburn getting inside. He was kind of a spark, if nothing else, in the first half.
He was. He played awful hard, made some nice shots and good moves to the inside, and really has a lot of fight in him, but he's got to find some help.
We expected Trey Lyles to be dominant. He has 7 points and 7 rebounds, but the real key player was Jeremy Tyler, number 22 for Tech.
Jeremy Tyler, big time moves on the outside, can drive the ball to the basket, had a nice dunk in the game. They just attacked the basket in the first half, and above all, they guarded.
Well, here are the first half stats presented by our friends at Subway.
Well, Lake Central 5 of 23 and 0 for 8 from the 3-point line, shot 21%. That really sums up the game. I don't know if it's as bad as shooting for Lake Central or that Tech just guarded them so well. Tech's only shooting 36%, 1 for 9 from 3. So 12 points off turnovers for Tech, 2 for Lake Central, and that's the difference in the game.
And of course, the block shots, been a number of those attributed to Trey Lyles, who've been very, very effective on the defensive end of the court. Back with the second half in just a moment on the Fox Sports Indiana.
Here comes coach. I'll get him on tape. Yep. All right, coach, give us an update if you could on Tyler Whiteman. Will we see him in the second half?
He's getting patched up as we speak. We better see him. We need him out there. looks like he's going to need some work done after the game, but he'll be fine for this.
What's going to be key to getting off a good start here in the third quarter?
We got to knock down an open shot, for one, and get our offense rolling. Defensively, I was pleased with our effort. Outside of Tyler hitting some shots, everybody else struggled a little bit from the field. Offensively, we're very uncharacteristic. We had 50% three-point shooters hitting the backboard, missing free throws. So we just got to settle down and knock them down when we can and take better care of the ball.
Coach, good luck.
Thank you.
Well, Dave Milosic's ball club is down at halftime 27-12. Let's get his thoughts right now.
All right, Coach, give us an update, if you could, on Tyler Wideman. Will we see him in the second half?
He's getting patched up as we speak. We better see him. We need him out there. Looks like he's going to need some work done after the game, but he'll be fine for this.
What's going to be key to getting off a good start here in the third quarter?
We got to knock down an open shot, for one, and get our offense rolling. Defensively, I was pleased with our effort. Outside of Tyler hitting some shots, everybody else struggled a little bit from the field. Offensively, we're very uncharacteristic. We had 50% three-point shooters hitting the backboard, missing free throws. So we just got to settle down and knock them down when we can and take better care of the ball.
Coach, good luck.
Thank you.
Bad shooting on the part of both ball clubs in the first half. Tech shot 36.4% and Lake Central 21-7. Lake Central, by the way, did not hit two shots in a row in the first half.
Now that's why they have 12 points, and Tech comes out in a 1-3-1 half court trap with Lyles on the front of it, and he committed kind of a silly foul right there.
Second foul of the game on Trey. Rebound advantage, as we showed you, 18-16, so not much difference there in favor of the Tech Titans. 7.7 rebounds for Lyles.
Yeah, Wideman's coming back in the game. He's now number 33, and it surely will help Lake Central as far as a positive attitude. Tech's going back man-to-man.
Yeah, the officials were informed of the uniform change, so there wouldn't be a technical foul involved in the officials. Tom Rohr, Scott Arthur, indeed Martin came over to tell us, just to reassure us, that he has changed to 33 because of the blood on the uniform. Long three, no good. And rebound on the floor, picked up by Josh Woodfield. Long three, and that's a pro three right there by Mikey Jones. He has two buckets. They've both been three-pointers.
That's kind of the way the day's been. Lake Central got inside play that time, couldn't make it, and Tech comes down and hits a three.
Well, I'm sure that Dave is a little concerned about his ball club shooting on the year. They shot 50%, 37% from the three-point zone. Here it is out of bounds now going back to Tech. Tech, on the other hand, 53% of the season, three-pointers, 37%, 11 turnovers now for Lake Central.
Great move there on the replay. Tech's coming out and really attacking, almost double-teaming the ball screen. That was one of the things that Lake Central did so well in the semi-state, coming off the ball screen, but not tonight. Tech, good coaching this week in practice.
Lyles dropped it off down inside. Whitfield couldn't get anything done with it, and looks like Jason wants a 30-second timeout. I think he's concerned a little bit. I'm just trying to read his mind from here, Mike Broughton. A little bit of, I almost said apathy. That's not the correct word. They're so far ahead right now that he's got to get them their attention back again, I think.
Yeah, he's got to get at. He's got trying to get after him a little bit here, try to get him going with 6:34 to go in the third quarter. But Tech played awful well in the first half, and Lake Central just needs to make a shot. If they could just make a shot, they can get back in.
Here's a guy that I've known forever. What a great guy, Landon Turner, the all-time rebounding leader at Tech High School, and of course went down to IU, had that terrible accident, and has kept just a great attitude. And we've been buddies forever. I think I just love the guy. In fact, I was at the school. As the driving layup goes in, I was at the school when Knight came out to recruit him. In fact, I got thrown out of the press conference because Knight says, "You can't be here." I said, "Fine with me."
Well, he's got a great spirit, and it's great he's here as Tech's having their way tonight.
Basket was by Jeremy Tyler at the Tech end of the court, by the way.
Weidman, nice play on the inside that time. Got the rebound and laid it in.
And when I say that Bob told me that, of course, he said it in gentler terms than that, if you know him.
I don't think he was very gentle in those times.
You can't be here. All right, Bobby, thank you. Here's the shot to the corner right side by Mikey Jones. Third bucket, third three-pointer.
Mikey Jones has made a big difference in this game because really everyone else is having trouble shooting the outside shot except him.
21-point lead now at 35-14. You know, he's absolutely right, was Dave Malostnik, because what's happened is that they're taking shots that they would normally make, and they can't, and they're not even coming close. There's a bucket by Wilburn. That followed the shot by Tyler. And it's a little chaotic. 30-second timeout taken by Lake Central.
That time Lake Central was trying to call timeout and they couldn't before they made the shot. So he kind of called it and then coach backed up and they got the layup.
Take a look at the other games today. Michigan City Marquette Catholic 70-66 over Bar Reeve in overtime. Micah Bullock won the Middle Attitude Award, 23 points. Addison Wagler, 25. Marquette Catholic Ryan Fizikas had 34 points and 10 rebounds. Westview didn't put up much of a match for Park Tudor, 84-57. And then Greensburg earlier tonight, 89-76. That's an all-time scoring high for Class 3A. Jamar Weaver of Westview won the Middle Attitude Award in 2A. Macy Holdsworth of Greensburg in 3A. So that's the way the games have shaped up so far on this full day of high school basketball championship at Bankers Life Fieldhouse.
Now Lake Central's going in a 1-3-1 half-court trap. Going to trap change things a little bit here.
37-16. Long rebound. Taken down by Jones. Put back up. Nice put back off the miss by Lyles. Mikey Jones. He's having a great third quarter. It's 8 points in the quarter now for him.
Now, that's what they did last week, Lake Central. That time they didn't trap the ball screen, so Wilburn was able to get to the inside and dish it off. Now, that's the way they looked against Homestead.
They had to play well against Homestead because Homestead was a good ball club. A lot of folks, once they saw that matchup, thought that Homestead might be down here.
Yeah, it was a close game through three quarters.
Here's that dunk by Weidman.
Maybe that'll get Lake Central going a little bit because that was a very nice play to the inside. Wilburn has great energy in the game for Lake Central.
The foul was on Tyler Ross. First of the second half on Tyler, third in the game. And now Joe Bannister goes out for Lake Central. And Robert Ryan comes in. And he'll replace Tyler Ross.
Lake Central just needs a couple good things to go for him. It's 21-point difference right now, but they're still fighting. They're still got a lot of hustle in them. Coach Malosnik's making them work pretty hard.
J.J. Walker. Second bucket for CJ, averaging 8.5 points a game. He has four. Halfway through the third quarter. It's been all Tech to this point of the game. They're 26-2 on the year. They lost to Bowman Academy, 68-64 in the second game of the season at Bowman, by the way. And then Hamilton Southeastern, the club a lot of folks thought might be here representing the northern half of the draw, got them late in the season. Here's a foul. It'll be on Lyles. That'll be number three on him. Southeastern got him by 677-71.
This is going to be a decision for Coach Delaney. Now, Lyles has three fouls. You're up 23 points, 339 in the third quarter. Do you leave him out there, or do you take him out and rest him a little bit? It'll be interesting here what he does.
Dickerman at the line. Not a good free throw shooter. Only 40% on the year.
Coach right now is talking to Lyles. He's trying to get his contact put back in, but this might be a time to rest him for a minute or two with the three fouls, especially with the big lead. I don't know, after last week, though, and where they had the 30-point lead and almost lost it, I would imagine he's going to stay out.
You know, I'm watching that game, and I'm not believing what I'm seeing, Mike, because they were coasting. They had Bloomington North down and had no problem whatsoever, and all of a sudden they found themselves just barely sneaking it out. Timeout has been taken, 3:39 to go. Third quarter, 41-19, Tech over Lake Central.
We welcome you back inside Bankers Life Fieldhouse. Tech 41-19, leading Lake Central but through the third quarter, and happy now to be joined by the commissioner of the IHSAA and Bobby Cox. And Bobby, you know, this is always one of the biggest days of the year for the association. Congratulations on another wonderful event.
Thank you, Greg, and it is a great day for IHSAA, great day for boys basketball in our state. We've had wonderful crowds, great fan support, and great play on the court.
What does the support of the Pacers and Fever mean for this event?
It's paramount in our continuation of basketball in the state of Indiana. We're honored and humbled to be partners with the Indiana Pacers and the Indiana Fever, and their support is vital for us to continue these great shows of basketball, and we're so happy to be with them and put these tournaments on.
A full house tonight. What does that mean for the IHSAA?
I'm extremely pleased that we sold out tonight. I thought we had a chance with the basketball excitement surrounding us in the city today and this weekend. I was hopeful, and it came to fruition, and I'm extremely pleased.
I know that it's a fun time of year. It's also a busy time of year. Enjoy a little rest over the next few days. We'll see you again for the spring championship season.
Thank you, Greg. Appreciate it.
Jerry?
The commissioner had a little back surgery a month or so ago. I'm doing well. We wish him the best.
I told him to take care of himself so he can swing that golf club.
Oh, that's all he cares about. I'm telling you right now. Bobby mentioned the attendance, and the number is staggering, 28,189 for the day. And as Bobby mentioned, pretty much a sellout tonight as Bannister hits 28,189.
Well, Bannister's 37% from three. Maybe he'll help get it going here a little bit.
41-21, lead still sizable at 20. Shot would have counted had it gone. It did not. And the foul's going to be called against number 22. That's going to be Dickelman. That'll be three on him.
Well, it's an interesting time for Tech right now because, you know, there was a lot of contact right there. It was a foul on Lake Central, but Lyles gets his fourth in the third quarter. Then they'll be playing some of the game without him, and it'd be interesting how they played without him. But so far, Lyles is still in there.
Not scoring a lot. His average is 24 points. He has eight. That's his first point of the second half. He had 1 point of the first quarter. Six in the second. Now one in the third. Meanwhile, Mikey Jones has scored 11 and Jeremy Tyler 14 for the Titans.
Yeah, I think Corey Dickelman and then Weidman, they've both done a good job on Trey Lyles tonight, using a lot of body and a lot of physical play on him.
But to Lyles' credit also, Mike, is the fact that he hasn't tried to force anything.
No, he's a team player. It's a team game, and he'll need that next year at Kentucky.
Long three. Nice shot that time by Menegheti. Who's the guy you were talking about?
Yeah, he hit five of them last week. He hit his first one. Maybe that'll light him up a little bit. I know he'll want to shoot it when he catches it.
That's his 58 of the year. He had hit 57 of 129 for 44% coming into this championship game here on this Saturday night.
You can tell from watching him play that he doesn't get many assists.
When it goes in, it doesn't come out, huh? Long three, no good. Rebound inside, taken down by Lake Central. And I think they may have got the rebound by virtue of a shove off. And if so, the foul's going to be against number 22. That's Dickelman, and that's going to be four on him.
Well, they're going to try to bring in Ross right now, and he's going to try to guard Lyle a little bit. Dickelman, that was a tough call right there. That could have gone either way, and it was fortunate for Indianapolis Tech that it went the way it did, because that had been Lyle's, Trey Lyle's fourth.
Now, right now, Dave Milosic's in a bit of a hustle as they get inside, and Lyle slams one home. Even if his guys are in foul trouble, Mike, he's going to have to leave them out there. They did take Dickelman out. But they're reaching the point where it's the point of no return.
Yeah, they got to keep their guys in the game. You know, they got to just keep them in the game and hope for the best.
Dropped off and a slam.
Those are two Division I dunks right there Weidman and Lyles. That's big time dunks.
Tyler Dahl with 10 points. He scored four in the first, shut out on the second, went to the locker room to get repaired. Came back out, changed uniforms. And has added 6 points. In fact, he's had three of their four field goals here in this quarter. Wide open three, right side. Nothing doing. Rebound yanked off in the middle that time by Bannister. Traveling violation.
Dunked by Lyles, held the rim and posed a little bit while he was up on the rim.
Second turnover of the second half. Here's another with the other end by Weidman. Whatever you can do, I can do equally.
Yeah, Weidman matched it. Well, not quite matched it, but he came close. They both got up awful high.
Now you can see that bandage that to wrap around the top of the head on Tyler. I'm just glad he's okay.
Yeah, he's had a good quarter coming back from injury.
Yep. 6 points in the quarter. Final minute of the third quarter, and they cut inside and get the easy layup. Somebody went to sleep that time defensively, and Tyler comes up with his 16th point of the game.
Nice pass by Walker that time. Lake Central comes out in a man-to-man press.
There's that three again by Menegheti. Well, you're right. When he gets it, it's just gone.
It's an NBA three.
10-footer right side is good by Tyler. 18 points now for Jeremy. That's two above his scoring average.
He's a great find for Ball State. Such a soft jump shot. Great form, great shot. Going to get to play a lot in the next level.
He passed 1,000 points this year. He and Rashawn Richardson, his teammate, are going to go to Ball State. So we've got a couple of guys that are going.
This has been really the first life in the game. Menegheti hits those two threes, but then Indianapolis Tech comes back and answers.
Mikey Jones gets his second foul. Now the change of the lineup. Chris Tuscan comes back onto the floor for Lake Central.
I think it's like what you said, Jerry. They got to get Dickelman back in the game at the quarter here with 10 seconds to go. Got to get him in.
Weidman, yeah. And he'll go to the line on the foul by Rashawn Richardson.
Weidman is tough on the inside right there. That's big-time rebound, big-time move, and he's hurting a little bit, but he's a Division I athlete, and he's going to be able to suck it up the last quarter. Looks like he's been in a World War II battle, looking at him on TV right now. But
as I mentioned, he's headed to Butler, and they're going to be able to use him. That foul came right at the end of the quarter. That's the reason he's up there by himself. And he does get the free throw. So Weidman has a nice third quarter, 4 points in the first half, and 9 in the third quarter alone for 13. But it's still a long way to go and a short time to get there. 49-32 Tech over Lake Central. Fourth quarter coming up now, 8 minutes to go. Arsenal Tech on top by 17 points, 49-32. They've led by as many as 23. Here's some numbers for you, Mike.
Well, 45% for Tech and 36% shooting for Lake Central is nothing to scream about. But at the bottom down there, Indianapolis Tech with only 5 turnovers in the basketball game. Lake Central likes to turn people over. And then fast break points, 12 for Tech, 4 for Lake Central. Lake Central just needs to try to get it to single digits with 3 or 4 minutes to go. If they could work it down a couple baskets, maybe they still have a shot in this basketball game.
Tech shooting 17 of 38 for the 45% Mike mentioned. Lake Central 13 of 36. Rebounds 25-21 in favor of Tech. And right now Lyles has 7, but that's what he had at the halftime. 7 points and 7 rebounds.
Lake Central comes out in a man-to-man press.
Oh, he turned it over. Looking to pass and change his mind, and that'll be the 6th turnover of the game for the Titans.
And Tech comes out in the fourth quarter, and Coach Delaney decides to keep the big guy out here to start the fourth quarter. So be interesting what Lake Central does here.
Yeah, let's just see how he approaches this fourth quarter. A slam inside by Weidman.
One dunk by Weidman, and Lyles is coming back to the scoring table, so he'd seen enough of that.
He's the first player in double figures now for Lake Central with 15, the only player in double figures. And we got a foul call against Lake Central.
It's like any team, Lake Central, when they start making a few baskets, they look pretty good out there playing the basketball game. It's just such a struggle the first half for them.
Fouls on Tuscan, number 34. First foul of the game on the 6'3 senior. Lake Central needs something to happen in a hurry. Here's the 3 from outside. It's tipped up and in by Weidman.
Nice play by Weidman. He got a little break, but nice tip in.
17 points now for Tyler. The average is 15.7. Leads the team in block shots with 40. Leads him in rebounds at 6'9", third in the ball club and assist with 46 coming into the game. 49-36 with the fourth quarter just getting underway.
Lyles is trying to post up on the inside. Tech trying to play very conservative right now. This is kind of interesting. They've had their way pretty much, and now they're trying to semi-hold it a little bit.
He's got 6 inches on his defender and a blocking foul.
Nice play on the inside. Weidman got up as high as Lyles did that time and tipped one in. So Butler maybe had 2-0.
He was not happy there. He thought that for a moment the Tech had turned the ball over, but the officials thought otherwise. 13-point ball game. It was 23 a few minutes ago. And now Tech throws it away.
Well, Tech had such a big lead that, I think what you said before, a little bit of apathy's set in. And, if Menengetti can get himself open and hit a 3 or they can get something good to happen, they take the thing down almost to single digits.
Right now, I would imagine Jason Delaney is going, wait a minute, I've seen this movie before. Last Saturday night, as a matter of fact, on Saturday afternoon over in Richmond. Ball is kicked away. So it'll stay in the possession now of Lake Central.
That position, great defense by Tyler that time because Menengetti was coming off a double screen right there. And he was going to launch that thing from dead down the middle. And he hits it. Lake Central's crowd's going to kind of go crazy here.
These possessions are getting to be more and more important as the game wears on. Weidman, high game this year, was 26 against Crown Point. Rebounds, 14 against Andrea and 13 against Portage. But the guy can get it done. He gets inside, misses a shot. It is put back up, and it's going to be a foul as Weidman goes right back at him, and I believe the foul's going to be on Justin Parker, 33, fouling 33. That's exactly what it is.
Weidman did a great job, again, attacking the basket, and sometimes he's in there rebounding against 4 Tech guys.
Yep.
And he's in there, and you see 1 white shirt and 4 in green, and he's coming up with the basketball.
Weidman only a 61% shooter on the year. On the free throw line. In fact, this is not a particularly good shooting club, Lake Central. They average 63% from the free throw line.
Weidman needs to make this free throw. If he makes this free throw, Tyler, if he makes it, they can get in some pressure here. chase Tech around a little bit.
17 points, 10 rebounds, a double-double now for Weidman, but he missed both those free throws, and they can ill afford to do that with the clock sitting still. 5:54 to go, fourth quarter, 49-36. Low-scoring game, which you would think might favor Lake Central. And Tech's going to take the air out of the ball a little bit. 5.5 to go. Oh, man. Lyles got smacked. No foul call. They bring it up. And the block shot, but a foul on Jeremy Tyler.
There's no place to go in that middle of that lane if you're a little soft at all, because there is a lot of contact on the inside. I guess this is why this is 4A basketball. They are really attacking each other inside.
Yeah, what I was impressed by that time, and I think you'll agree, Mike, that Lyles got smacked pretty good. He just shook his head and came right back to play defense.
Yep, he sure did. He's grown up a lot. I know Indianapolis Tech is very proud of him. I know Victor Bush, he's the athletic director there, and he's a good friend of mine, and he just said he's grown by leaps and bounds, and that's part of it. He took the kind of a bad call and just ran down to the other end.
We've talked about him being Mr. Basketball. The last time Mr. Basketball was from an Indianapolis public school was Washington's George McGinnis in 1969. Big Mac, also personal friend. They had him a Mr. Basketball in 52, and another close buddy that we missed dearly, Joe Sexton. Mr. Basketball won the Trester Award, and another steal. And the layup is good. And the basket by Bannister. And I think Mr. Delaney's had all he wants to see of this.
Great job by Lake Central, pressure in there.
A 23-point lead is sunk to 9 with 5 minutes and 8 seconds to go for the 4A championship.
Well, Mike, Lake Central has outscored Tech 8-0 in this fourth quarter.
It's 11-0 run by Lake Central, and again, Indianapolis Tech's kind of holding the basketball in a semi-delay, and Lake Central just keeps on playing. And they're rebounding the ball on the inside and attacking, and we got us a basketball game.
So, Tech's going to face full court pressure now from all over the court with 5 minutes and 8 seconds to go. Titans get it in. They get into the hands of Mikey Jones. Jones with 11 points. They have not been able to go inside to the big guy. In fact, that's him right there. Lyles has been on the fringe, and he'll get fouled as he goes by. That will be on Tuscan.
Lake Central has really pushed Indianapolis Tech way out on the floor there. Trey Lyles was going to drive the ball from about 23 feet, and they're trying to send some help. Lake Central's trying to send some help to slowing down. So Lake Central's pressure has really bothered them here in the last couple minutes.
Fourth quarter of play, 4A championship, 9-point ball game. What was once a blowout at 23, all of a sudden got a little life to it. Almost a turnover. Jones going one-on-one on Weidman. And picked off. Turnover by Tech is number 9 in the game. Now a basket would be oh so big, especially a one-on a three-point play. Loose ball on the floor, picked up by the Titans. Goal. Three-point field goal, Jeremy Tyler.
That was like a dagger right there, especially after Lake Central had missed the layup.
21 points of the game, and a reach-in foul is going to be called on C.J. Walker. Take a look at this three again, right in the corner.
Great pass by Walker. Tyler wide open, knocks it down, takes the lead back to double digits.
22nd three-pointer of the year for C.J. There he is on your screen. That's 22 Jeremy Tyler for Tech.
Lake Central coaching staff has to be proud of their team and their effort here in this last quarter and a half. They started hitting a few shots, picked up their defense, and they're just attacking Indianapolis Tech right now. Tech making a lot of turnovers here in the fourth quarter.
Wilburn to the line. He's averaging just under 12 points a game in the tournament. 4.3 assists, but that time no good. They can't afford to let any opportunities get away right now. Less than 4 to go. Foul prior to the shot.
Coach Delaney's got them kind of in a semi-delay right now where they're trying to spread the court, and they're wanting certain players, I think maybe three of them, Walker and Tyler or Trey Lyles, to drive the ball to the basket. Lake Central trying to trap when they can and trying to push it down on offense.
Walker has not been to the line yet tonight. Sophomore. 6 foot sophomore, averaging 8.5 points, just under 2 rebounds a game. Free throw shooter, not bad, 72% of the year.
I think Lake Central is going to go offense defense now with Meningetti. He's a little slow of foot on defense, but he can shoot the three on offense. Yeah. So they're going to make some offensive and defensive switches here the last 4 minutes.
Second free throw is good. And we got a timeout now with 3 minutes and 45 seconds remaining. Fourth quarter of play, 4A championship game. Looked like a blowout, not so much right now. Tech up by 13. Here come the Tech Titans back out. A little bit concerned there for the moment. They had a lead of 23 at one point. I think back to that possession about 4 or 5 ago. Mike, you made reference to it when Lake Central had it. If they score at that point, we're down to single digits.
Yep, they got it down to 9, and they had a chance with the layup to go to 7. That's really 3 possessions, and they missed the shot, and the 3-point shot by Tyler.
So give them credit. They have stayed right with the game, even though they were down big time early on. Inside, they missed another gimme. Back up again by Weidman, and to no avail, but a foul's going to be called. This time, the foul's going to be on Lyles. And that should be 4 on him. It is 4 on Trey.
Now Lake Central, if they were smart and the coaching staff talked to the team, they would attack Lyles every time now on defense because he's not going to foul out of this game. He's going to be running from the next foul. But Lake Central, they have chances. They miss layups. They're missing free throws. Like you said, they don't shoot it really well from the free throw line, but they work so hard and come out of some of these possessions with either 0 point or 1 point. Now they sub Minighetti out on defense. They're going to bring him back in on offense. Have two misses in a row.
They have missed four free throws, five in this quarter. They've missed five of the seven that they have had of the quarter. 13-point ball game with 3:15 to go.
I think Tech's looking for a layup, looking for a drive. They got the floor spread. They got Lyles in the middle.
They got to be careful here for the offensive foul if you're Lyles. Out of bounds to Lake Central.
Yeah, I think that was a pretty good play by Lyles that time. They're in a kind of a box set. They got Lyles in the middle. He turned and faced. There's not much help. He could drive the ball to the basket. A little off balance on the shot. But, again, that was a good play, I think, by Indianapolis Tech.
Lake Central with a busy roster. They've got seven seniors on the roster. Tech has nine.
Now you got Indianapolis Tech standing in a 2-3 zone. Watch out for Minighetti.
Lyles grabs it. Look out for throw on the elbows. You got to be careful now. Lyles got to take it coast to coast. Puts it back outside now. And they'll set up the offense. And a foul. It could be a lot of fouls in the final 2.5 minutes here because of the situation where they've got to stop the clock. Foul is on Ross. That's four on Tyler.
Well, Justin Parker, he's a 65% free throw shooter. That almost looked like that was a little bit intentional. I think Coach Malosnick, I think he's trying to foul a little bit, trying to drag the game out a little more like you see in the college.
Parker with 4 points off from the free throw line and five attempts.
Well, Indianapolis Tech's making the free throws, and Lake Central are missing the free throws, and that's quite an advantage here late in the game.
They're one out of two. That may be from behind on Tyler Ross. He got a handle the basketball, but climbed over the back of somebody inside, and that's where it's going to be on Tyler Ross. That's going to be five on him.
Well, Minighetti got the shot that he wanted and what the team wanted, and he was a little long on the shot, and they went after the rebound and fouled. And
well, here's part of the problem, Mike. Ross has gone out now, one of the starters with no points. Dickelman, another starter, has one. Bannister, another starter, has six. So it's been Weidman and Wilburn, and Wilburn only has eight. Weidman now with 17. So they didn't get a lot of points out of a couple of their starters.
And Mikey Jones here is not really the guy you want to foul. He's shooting 91% from the free throw line. So I guess of all the people to climb on somebody's back, I'm sure Coach Delaney likes to see number 23 on the free throw line at 91. You just don't see that very often over 90% for the season this late in the year.
And you can see why.
Nice touch and two more.
Jones now with 13 points. 2:25 to go. Jumper is good. And a very, very quick timeout. As the basket does count. And we'll take a break. 56-42. Titans still on top with 2:19 to go on the IHSAA Champions Television Network. We mentioned this is Jason Lenny's third year at the school. They had won 17 games total in the 3 years before he got there. During Trey's sophomore year, they won 16. They were 21-5 a year ago, and this year they're 26-2. What a turnaround job Jason's done there.
He really talked on Media Day about the four seniors and how dedicated they were over the last 3 years, the four senior starters, to lead Tech to the victories.
Wilburn on the steal, gets inside, missed the shot, and draws the foul.
Boy, Wilburn is a fantastic athlete there. He missed that charging foul and was able to jump off his left foot, fly to the right, almost put it in, and needs to make these free throws because it was a painful move right there.
Well, they just have done nothing from the line. They've missed five of the seven shots in this fourth quarter.
He begged that one in, but did, you know, Wilburn is a... he's a tough competitor, one of the toughest competitors of the day. He just keeps on fighting and guarding and making plays.
Well, the whole team has done that. They haven't given up even when they were down by 23. They've kept coming back, but it just doesn't look too good if you're a Lake Central fan right now.
Great play that time, great pass on the inside. And again, you got number 23, Mr. Jones, shooting the basketball. He's 90%, has a great shot from the free throw line. And so that's just the guy that Lake Central doesn't want to foul.
Now for Mikey.
Mikey's had a really good game. He shot the ball, hit the outside shots when really no one on either team was making them. And doing a good job here at the free throw line late in the game.
Got them both.
Good pass to the inside for Weidman because Lyles wasn't going to foul.
19 now for Tyler. And traveling call against Tech with a minute 42 to go and down by 13.
There was Wilburn again, guarding one man, leaving him, going to another man, and got Tech all kind of rattled right there. Tech should slow down a little bit now with a minute 42 to go.
Titans on the year, the average win margin was 19 points a game. At the tournament, it was 18 points a game. Haven't had a lot of close ones. Hard to the hoop, dished off left side. Nice little left-handed layup by Dickelman. That's his first field goal of the game.
Coach Malaznik is really dragging this game out. It's a minute 26. He calls another timeout. They set up the pressure again after the made basket.
All right, Lake Central has one timeout left. We'll take a timeout ourselves at a minute 26 to go. 58-47, Tech leads Lake Central. Tech has let Lake Central get back into the game here, Mike. It's a look at the numbers over here. Trey Lyles has not scored in the fourth quarter. In fact, he has scored only 4 points in the entire second half.
You know, one thing about Lake Central, they're down 11, but they've missed 11 free throws in this basketball game. And another steal by Lake Central.
And a good-looking drive by Wilburn. Boy, this kid has really played well.
Wilburn, great move, and another timeout. I think that might be coach's last.
That's
but
it.
Minute 11, they're down 9. They got it to single digits here with a minute 11 to go.
They were down by 23 points at one point of the game. They were down 14-4 at the end of the first quarter. Halftime was 27-12.
third quarter, 49-32. The lead stretched to 23, and all of a sudden, you look up, and you made comment, Mike, about this. Lake Central continued to play hard, and they got a couple of three-pointers, and I go back to them. You talked about Minighetti. He had 2 3-pointers almost back-to-back in the third quarter. That kind of lifted him a little bit, but unfortunately, he hasn't been able to do anything since then.
Yeah, one time it was 41-19, and then, again, Lake Central, these 11 missed free throws, would they be right there? Yeah. As poorly as they shot the ball in the first half, they would be there at the end. Well, they might even be ahead here with a minute to go, but... I think he's out of timeouts now, the coach Milosnik from Lake Central, and so now they got to play through this. They got to try to steal the ball or try to foul quickly and, again, drag the game out as far as it can go for as many possessions as possible, because you're down 4 possessions in the game.
Yeah. I've watched a lot of basketball this year, as I'm sure you have, and I think this has been one of the poorest free throw shooting years I have seen in a long time, both at the college level and the high school level, and I don't have an answer for it.
I just think it's a lack of focus. You know, everybody's into the dunks and the spinning moves and the three-point shots, and then they neglect the free throws and really neglect the things that Greensburg took care of in the last game, and that's why they're state champions.
And I don't think it's the coaches skipping that part of the practice session at all.
I was criticized when my teams would miss free throws. It's like, well, you didn't practice them all week. You practice them every day.
Yeah.
And sometimes, again, it's focus. They got to pay more attention to what they're doing.
But I do think your point is well made, as the foul's going to be tagged on to Lake Central center Weidman. I think what's happened, it's they want to be on Sports Center, for God's sake. You know, I want a dunk. I want this. Come on, you know. I mean, you're right. Your point is well made. If Lake Central shoots their free throws, and you, what did you say, 11 misses?
Yeah, 11 misses, and they're down 9.
And
so
you wonder how many of those might have been 1-1.
Right.
So we're talking about more than 11 points.
But, you know, kids want to make the three and then point 3 fingers at the crowd and stare at people instead of just playing the game the way it was meant to be played.
Lyles of the line. First point, fourth quarter, 12 of the game.
Well, that's one thing about Indianapolis Tech right now. In the last couple minutes, they made 5 free throws in a row. Mikey Jones made 4. Trey comes to the line and makes 1. So he's 5 in a row for Indianapolis Tech. 10-point lead.
Well, they're 8 out of 10 in the quarter. There's a big swing. You take their 8 and the ones that you missed in the fourth quarter, third quarter. Lyles with a double-double now. 12 points, 11 rebounds. Weidman comes off of the board. Spin move inside by Wilburn. Goes all the way to the hole and got it.
They need to attack Indianapolis Tech because Lyles doesn't want to foul out of the game.
And a quick foul. Ty Wilburn says, I may get beat, but I'm not going to go down without fighting. He has 7 points in the quarter, 15 points in the game.
Coach Milosnik's doing a great job here. I mean, he's going to make more possessions because they're fouling within 3 or 4 seconds, making Indianapolis Tech go to the line. You know, some of the players from Indianapolis Tech have to be thinking a little bit about last week. And so, you know, it's in your mind. Maybe they could foul somebody besides Lyles or Mikey Jones, but Lake Central's fighting back. They just got to keep scoring on the offensive end so they can set up the pressure.
Lyles now 2 out of 3 in this quarter. He is 7 for 9 in the game.
He's an awful good free throw shooter. He's just a good outside shooter, pure shot, nice form. That's why he's maybe Mr. Basketball.
Wilburn getting inside again.
No timeouts now, so they just got to play through it, and they foul again. They foul Trey Lyles. He's made 2 of the last 4, so maybe that is a good foul.
Trying to recall what college game was that I watched.
St. Louis.
St. Louis, yeah.
St. Louis fouled. It almost, I think, 20 or 25 possessions in the last 2 minutes. It was 14-point game with like 3 minutes to go, and came back and won the game.
Well, Jim Cruz just said, okay, here's our game plan in the last 2 or 3 minutes. We're going to foul you. If you make them, well, okay, congratulations. If not, well.
Yeah, it worked to perfection for Coach Cruz that night, and Trey was begging that one in right there because that ball hit the front of the rim, hit the back of the rim, and dropped in, and he fell over the line. I know we can get it to 15 feet.
Not much time left in this ball game. Weidman outside. Here's the 3. And Minighetti got it. And again, he gets his third three-pointer, 9 points of the night, 62-56. With 30 and a half to go.
Great job by Lake Central. I mean, Menengetti's wide open. Now, that's something that Indianapolis Tech coach Delaney needs to be talking. Don't leave him open. There's a lot of guys out there that could shoot the outside shot for Lake Central, but he is not the one you would want Indianapolis Tech, if you were the coach, to have him shoot that shot, because right now we got us a two-possession game.
Lyles, 15 points, 11 rebounds. This is Dickelman at the line. He's 1-for-5 from the line tonight.
Lake Central needs to block out the shooter here so they can get the rebound.
Tell you, we're two possessions here. You might need a three. I might be looking for Menengetti. Here's the layup off the mark this time. Save. Menengetti trying to chase it down. He does. Picked up by Lake Central. Off of the near side. Here is the three. Good by Ty Wilburn.
What a shot by Wilburn at 21% for the season. And we are down, just like last week, at 62-59 with 11 seconds to go.
12 points in the quarter for Wilburn, 20 points on the night. What a game he's had. Wilburn's hit 8 of 14 from the field, 1 out of 4 three-pointers, 3 of 5 free throws.
Well, these are pretty big free throws right now, because Lake Central can come down the court for this last possession with a chance to tie this basketball game.
And we get one of the Tech players down, C.J. Walker.
Yeah, he's their point guard right now. I think it looked like he kind of pulled a muscle right
there.
Yeah,
that's what it looks like, yeah.
So he's going to have to come out of the basketball game, so Tech's going to have to sub. And Lyles, I would say this is the biggest free throws of his high school career right here.
I could not disagree with that at all.
He's got to make one. Then they need to get back and defend. And it'll be interesting what Lake Central does, whether they try to shoot the three or try to lay it in again. There's really not much defense for Tech at this time, because Lyles doesn't want to foul out of the game. Oh, my goodness. One more shot. The second one's always tougher than the first one when you miss the first one.
I'll tell you, if this doesn't go in, we got ourselves a heck of a finish here. So reminiscent of last week from Bloomington North.
Coach Delaney has to, right now, he needs to be talking to somebody to know where Menengetti is at right now. They need to find him.
And this place is going crazy. Oh, that is so big. Now they come down. Now you don't have to have the three. That's way off the mark. Lyles picks it up, throws it up in the air with 2 seconds, 1 second, game over. Tech manages to dodge a bullet, 63-59.
What a game at the end for Lake Central to come back, and a great win for Indianapolis Tech. First time since 1980 Indianapolis Public Schools won the state basketball championship.
Well, I can't say enough about Ty Wilburn. Here's a young man who had 8 points through three quarters. Did not score in the first quarter. Ends up with 20. He almost brought him back on his back.
He had a great game, and Lake Central should be very proud of their effort. They missed a lot of shots in the first half, but there was no quit in that team, and that's why they're here in Indianapolis on the last week of March.
Just a tremendous basketball game. That if you dialed away anywhere in the second or third quarter, you missed one whale of a game, because it was a 23-point lead at one time. And you just know Jason is saying, oh, my goodness, here we go again.
I think Jason is glad there's no more games next week. After the last two games he's had, I'm going to be checking to see if he's bald next week.
What a job. Well, let's give Tech credit, though. We said a lot about Lake Central sticking in there, and I can't say enough about them. Tech could have pulled it up also. Mike, they could have said, oh, wait a minute. Not that they would have lost the game, but they had some troubles, and they overcame them.
And Tech also, for three quarters, played really, really well. They were great on the defensive end because part of Lake Central's woes on offense was that Lake Central forced them so far out to shoot the ball.
Well, let's see what the winning coach has to say. Here's Jason Delaney.
Jason, apparently a flair for dramatic over the last couple of fourth quarters. Regardless of it, you're a state champ for a second time. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. You know, it's all sinking in now because you think you're putting the game away and then you're missing free throws and it comes down to the very, very end. You know, it's just a wide range of emotions, but the one that's starting to kick in now is that, you know, this is the last game I get to coach these guys, and they have been absolutely wonderful. I love these kids to death. You know, there's four of them that were there from the very beginning when there were seven guys showing up, Trey, Mikey, Josh, and Jeremy, and then, you know, CJ came in and what he's meant to the program, and just all these guys. Justin Parker played a great game. You know, a lot of the guys didn't play tonight, and but they're all go down as champions.
This is more than about Tech. This is about IPS. First state title in basketball for an IPS school since Broad Ripple in 1980. What does that mean to you?
It inspires people. I mean, you look at this crowd. These young men have inspired people to come back that hadn't been to a high school basketball game in years. And what they're doing, too, is inspiring the little kids in the elementary and middle schools and even other IPS schools. You know, for 34 years, it hasn't been done. A lot of times being told they couldn't be done, and now we're an example of it can be done.
Jason wants to go enjoy it. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Jerry.
Second state championship for Jason Delaney to go along with the one he won in 2004 in Class A with the Waldron Mohawks when they went 27-0. That was sweet, but this might be even sweeter.
Of the 2014 Arthur L. Chester.
I've got to go to the PA across the way, Scott Gregg, as we get to the Mental Attitude Award presentation.
Presenting the Arthur L. Chester Mental Attitude Award on behalf of the IHSAA Executive Committee is Mr. Phil Ford of Jay County High School.
We would like to welcome Jim Morris, President of Pacer Sports and Entertainment, to assist with the presentation of the Arthur L. Chester Mental Attitude Award for Class 4A Boys Basketball. On behalf of the Indiana Pacers and Indiana Fever, presenting sponsors of the Boys Basketball State Tournament, the IHSAA Executive Committee will award a $1,000 scholarship to the winner's school. Please join us in thanking the Indiana Pacers and Indiana Fever for their generous support of student athletes and high school basketball in our state. After we announce the name of the recipient, we invite his parents to join him on the arena floor. The recipient of this award was selected by the IHSA Executive Committee. This student was nominated by his principal and coach and excelled in mental attitude, athletic ability, scholarship, and leadership. The winner of the 2014 Arthur L. Chester Mental Attitude Award for Class 4A Boys Basketball is Trey Lyles of Indianapolis Arsenal Tech.
Trey Lyles ranks at the top 5% of his senior class of 446 students. He's the third student in school history to receive the IHSAA Mental Attitude Award, all in boys basketball, joining Emmett Lowry in 1929 at the Gimmel Award way back then, and Joe Sexton in 52. He is the son of Jesse and Tom Lyles of Camby. Of course, Tom, one of the assistant coaches on this ball club. What a career this young man has had. He played, they originally was born in Saskatoon, Canada, played for Canada in the FIBA Under-19 World Championships in Prague, Czechoslovakia this past summer. And Canada lost to Spain in the fifth-place game there. 3.8 GPA. He's not just a basketball player.
That's quite an honor when you're one of the best players in the state to trust the award. And who knows, maybe Mr. Basketball. He had the trifecta.
Well, there are four or five candidates for it. Let's go out now to Greg.
All right, Tom, Jesse, and Trey with us. I think folks know that your basketball talent is pretty evident here. They may not know top 5% of your senior class at Arsenal Tech. What does this award mean to you?
I'm just thankful for it, just being recognized for my academic success, and I just want to thank my parents for pushing academics on me.
You certainly know that your athletic career is going to continue at Kentucky, potentially pro basketball after that. What does it mean for you to cap off your high school career with a state championship?
It means the world. I just want to thank my fellow teammates over there. Without them, this wouldn't be possible. Tighten up, baby. Tighten up.
Dad is on the bench with you during games. Mom is usually at the scorer's table. Mom, how you feeling right now?
I'm very happy. We're very proud of him. He's worked very hard, and we're very proud of everything that he's done.
All right, Tom, Jesse, and Trey, guys, congratulations. Jerry.
Nice young man. Well deserving. And again, that just might add that little bit to the Mr. Basketball thing. You never know. This is going to be a tough decision this year. Final again, 63-59. Back with more from Bankers Life Fieldhouse in just a moment. We are watching the Sharp Business Systems Awards celebration. These are the runner-up medals being presented to the Lake Central team. 22-3 on the year. The Indians finish up 22-4. And I know, and we say this every time, Mike Broughton, that it's nothing to be ashamed of. It is still tough. And one of the things they emphasize in the Monday meetings when the coaches and athletic directors come in is sportsmanship when you are the runner-up.
Yeah, you know, if the game's a 25-point game, the runner-up, people are okay with it. But when you come down to the last possession like this, it's tough. And Lake Central, they carried themselves with great pride today and did a quality job. They just ran a little short.
Well, they've had a heck of a year. And Dave Milosevic, in his 10th year up there at the school, he knows what it's like to play for a championship. He was a defensive back at Highland when they lost to Ben Davis back in 87 for the 5A football championship, 14-7. So another close affair there. So he's been there, done that.
He's come from a coaching family, and he's a tough guy. He didn't like the media meeting. He just wanted to come out on the court on Monday.
You know, it's funny you should say that, because I talked with him, and then I was talking to Marvin Ray, Bowman, and I looked around, he was gone. Marvin had done bugged out, man. I don't blame him. You saw the champion, the runner-up trophy, and now we'll get the presentation of the championship medals. Members of the IHSAA Executive Committee, they've already got their championship t-shirts on.
Yeah, and Victor Bush, the athletic director of Indianapolis Tech, is going to put the medals on him, and I know he's very proud of that. I've been with him this week, and he was nervous as can be. I said, hey, you're not coaching, man. You're just the athletic director.
Yeah, Victor's the AD. Larry Yarrell is the principal. Robin Tobias, the principal at Lake Central. Tony Bartolomeo, Lake Central athletic director, members of the New England Conference.
I think Victor's very proud of just the way that they carried themselves all year through some adversity, through some tough finishes where they held on and different things like that. And again, it's quite a deal, because the last time I remember Indianapolis Tech playing was 1966. They were runner-up, and that was a long time ago.
Well, before Joe Sexton passed away, he was a longtime Butler coach and became a good friend. All the years, he talked about Tech. He never got the green out of his blood, so to speak. So once you're there, you're there. And you could see a while ago when you saw Landon Turner how enthused he was.
I think a lot of the crowd was the history of Tech. And there's great history not only in basketball but in a lot of sports. They used to have the state track meet there for years.
Yeah.
And I mean, it's just a fantastic place, and the administration ought to be really proud. And you don't get many Trey Lyles, but when you get them, you make the most of it.
And they did.
And they made the most of it.
Here comes Trey right here. They had a pretty good football program going this year. They had a couple of missed combobbles there, but they got that turned around.
Well, there'll be other teams, like Coach Delaney said, there'll be other kids now in the city that are going to see this tonight. And they're going to be out practicing, and they're going to try to make it happen for them. So IPS is back, and the whole city of Indianapolis, it's tough playing basketball in the city.
And the folks down in Lexington ought to really get excited about what's going to happen again. Let's go to the sideline again.
Ride like for you and your team.
Unbelievable. I'll have a better answer for you if you call me next week when I can reflect upon it. Right now, just thinking about my guys, and awfully proud of the effort that they put forth in the fourth quarter. And thinking that we let one get away from us tonight, knowing how bad we played in the first half and still had a chance to win.
All of your team showed effort and guts, but you even had one guy that was kind of bloodied, battered, and bruised. Your thoughts about Tyler Wyman's after being nearly knocked out of the game late in the second quarter?
I hope everybody in Central Indiana sees the type of tough guy Butler's getting. He's going against a potential lottery pick in there, and it was a war. And I just can't say enough about how much he battles, what a great teammate he is, And he's going to make Butler a better basketball team because he's a great teammate and he plays so doggone hard.
Dave, congratulations on a wonderful season. Thanks for the time.
Thanks for the kind words. I appreciate it.
Derek?
You know, I had a chance to meet Dave for the first time in the Monday meeting. What a gentleman. What a well-spoken young man he is.
Yes, he's a great young coach, and the future looks good for Lake Central because those kids up north will be doing the same thing, starting to practice tomorrow.
That's a very good point. We'll take a break and come back and wrap things up on a full day of basketball at Bankers Life Fieldhouse here on Fox Sports Indiana.
The 104th Annual IHSAA Boys State Finals are brought to you by the Indiana Pacers and Indiana Fever, presenting sponsor of the IHSAA State Basketball Tournament and honored to support Indiana's game at all levels. And by Methodist Sports Medicine in collaboration with IU Health, official sports medicine provider to the IHSAA. Subway, eat fresh. Wilson Sporting Goods, the official ball of the IHSAA. Farmers Insurance, we are insurance, we are farmers. The Indianapolis Colts, the IHSAA is proud to be Colt Strong. Sharp Business Systems, saluting great athletes and even better students. Sport Graphics, turning our creativity and experience into your results. And by Fox Sports Indiana, home of the IHSAA Champions Network.
There's a look at your 2014 channel of the Class 4A state champions. Time now for the Farmers Insurance highlight of the game. How about Mr. Lyles here?
That's a big time move right there. Be one that ESPN highlights.
You betcha. Time for the Farmers Insurance highlight of the game package. Trey Lyles finished up with 16 points and 12 rebounds in the game tonight. And we'll take a look at the final stats now for this ball game tonight. Individually, Jeremy Tyler with 19 for Tech, 16 for Lyles, 15 for Mikey Jones. Lake Central was led by the 20 points of Ty Wilburn and the 19 points of Tyler Weidman. Here are the numbers, Coach.
Well, Lake Central shot 60% in the second half to bring their total up to 44% for the game, which got them back in it. Made a few threes. Biggest stat right there is free throws. Arsenal Tech 23 of 32. Lake Central 7 of 18, and those 11 misses were probably the difference in the game.
In fact, Tech hit 11 of 18 free throws in the fourth quarter of this game tonight. So our congrats going out to the Tech Titans as they begin to cut the nets down here at the field house.
I want to thank you, Jerry Baker. You're an icon of Indiana basketball. You and Mr. Carnegie and Hilliard Gates. And I'm telling you, I've listened to you guys when I coached and when I was a little kid all those years. And it's an honor.
It's an honor
to be an Indiana basketball coach all those years, especially when you are part of the state final lore. Thank you very much for being a part of this.
Our thanks to everybody for their hard work today. And our congrats to all the champions here on Fox Sports Indiana.